Well, Kelly Iko, the Houston Rockets beat reporter for The Athletic, reported on Twitter that Carmelo Anthony and PJ Tucker probably will not be seen on this floor together at the same time this season. According to the tweet, Rockets head coach Mike D'Antoni wants Carmelo on the floor when Tucker is off, and vice versa. He sees them both as fours. So, how is this going to work out? We all know that Carmelo does not want to come off the bench. Keisha, will there be harmony in Houston?
Mike, I'm going to start off with a quote. Whatever I have to do to help this team win a championship, that's what's going to be done. Who said that? None other than Carmelo Anthony. Now, this is not a definite admission that he is willing to come off the bench. However, this is a move from the outright scoff that he gave when he was in Oklahoma City and a reporter mentioned him coming off the bench. He just poo-pooed that right off the bat and basically told the reporter, like, you don't even, that's just ridiculous. How dare you even mention it? It's ludicrous. Now, so we might be moving in the right direction. However, why is it that we must assume that Carmelo has to come off the bench? I know that he's, you know, it seems like Carmelo is paying for the sins of Oklahoma City. I think that that wasn't the right fit for him, and it showed. He had one of his worst seasons in his entire career. And when I think about him being in New York before he went to OKC for that 1 year, he was still the Carmelo that we knew. So I just found it hard to believe that his skills just dropped off that that quickly and that drastically. So he is with Houston now. He's with Chris Paul, who's very close to him off the court. He spoke with Chris Paul and he spoke to James Harden, and they play pickup games, and there seems to be a real flow and real chemistry, and those two see how he can be effective within the Houston Rockets offense. But now it's time for Mike D'Antoni, head coach of the Rockets, to show us what he can do.
Which, if it was something that he didn't think that he could do, then Rockets never would have gone after Carmelo Anthony in the offseason. I think that the Rockets have a nice team here. They came so close to getting to the NBA Finals after losing to the Golden State Warriors in seven games last season. Look, I think start or coming off the bench, Carmelo Anthony will have a big impact on this offense this season. There's no question about it. Keisha, you pointed out the lack of production that he had in Oklahoma City last season. We saw that. There's no question. But what do you expect when you're playing with a guy like Russell Westbrook and, of course, Paul George? So, of course, we expected that those numbers were going to decline, and which they certainly did. Not to mention, I kind of looked at Oklahoma City, even though they made the playoffs and everything, but it was almost like it was a season in purgatory for him. He never looked comfortable in that uniform. He never really looked comfortable when he was on the court necessarily. He got off to a very good start those first 10 games, I think, with OKC. But after, like, you know, a quarter of the season, his numbers started to tail off, and he just didn't really seem like he was comfortable. And then there was this whole thing, was what was his actual role going to be? I think here in Houston, Mike D'Antoni has an opportunity to be very creative here. And I think what's ultimately going to wind up happening is they will bring Carmelo off the bench. I think PJ Tucker, a guy who's one of, if not, you know, he's one of the top five defensive players, top 10 defensive players in the NBA. The guy is a force. No question about that. I think you got to keep him in the rotation. But we also got to remember, you know, injuries could happen, things that, you know, that we don't expect. At the same time, the Rockets could be in the mix to make some upgrades once the season begins, because they realize that they are a contender to go ahead and win the Western Conference. But I think, like you pointed out, Mike D'Antoni, this is really up to him to kind of figure out what's going to be the best fit for this offense and for this team as they try to make a push to unseat the Golden State Warriors in the West.